Hey, Ninja! I'm so excited to share with you today how to add beautiful countdown timers to your Canva presentation slides. I hadn't seen anyone doing it quite this way until I saw Louise Henry doing it in a presentation that I went to, and I wanted to share with you how you too can make this happen in your Canva presentation. So if you don't know me, I'm Misty Dorman from mistydorman.com and lifeninjatraining.com. I help overwhelmed entrepreneurs implement systems, strategies, tools, and tech to save time and mental calories growing their biz. If you want more of these types of videos, please leave your vote by giving it a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe. It truly is the best compliment that you can give me, and it helps boost the algorithm so I can reach more people with these great tips. So without further ado, I'll show you how I did this, and I'll even give you a template that you can use to just easily pull this into your own Canva. Okay, so let's go over to my template. All right. Okay, so at the beginning of the template are your instructions, so you'll be able to just follow through and do it on your own. I got these timers from timertopia.wordpress.com/new-timers. So the link is right there. You can grab it. I'll go ahead and open this up. Okay, so when you open up Timertopia, you're going to see options for all different kinds of countdown timers. I only stuck a few in your template because I don't know what you need access to. I don't know how you're going to use this exactly. The way I'm going to use it is I run Action Taker workshops inside of my Life Ninja Academy membership. I also will sometimes do masterclasses, workshops, that type of thing, outside of Life Ninja Academy. And I'm all about taking action, right? Like, let's just get it done right then and there. And so I'll do a slide like you saw me showing at the beginning, where we're just going to stop for a few minutes and take action and just get it done so that, you know, you don't have a list of things to do after the workshop. So you may be doing something like that in your home business, or you might be using it a different way. That's okay. So anyway, you're just going to grab whatever timer you need if I don't already have it in the template. And let me just grab the 30-minute timer. Okay, and then you're just going to right-click and do Save Image As. And just save it somewhere easy to grab. And you can add it right back into this template that I've given you. Okay, so first you're going to receive your template, and you create your own. That's totally fine. If you get the one from me, you'll need to just click the link and click to copy the template so you have your own copy of it. Okay, my screen recording software is giving me trouble today, or might be my computer is a little bogged down. So I'm just taking my face off of here so that it's not slowing things down. Okay, so then what you're going to do is add a page and go to uploads and upload your timer that you just grabbed. And then you're just going to pull it over here and resize it however you'd like. You can always resize it to a different size in your own presentation, or you could have pulled this directly into your presentation. So you don't have to put it on this template and then move it to your presentation. But I like having a template so that I can reuse it over and over again. So you're going to put it there. You're going to copy and paste and put another one in exactly the same spot. Okay, hang with me here. I know that might seem weird, but go with it, okay? And then while you have the top one selected, you're gonna hit crop. And what you wanna do is crop it down to just the seconds or just the minutes. I'm going to do seconds. Okay. So that's going to make it so you're only seeing that portion of the timer. Okay. And then you're going to grab the other one and do the same thing, but with the opposite side. Okay. So if you did the seconds, you're doing the minutes section now. If you did the minutes, you're doing the seconds section now. Okay. All right. So then what you have is the entire timer, but without the colon in the middle, and it's got a white background. So you'll be able to add that to your presentation and, you know, design around it, right? So over to my example here. Okay. So how did I do this, right? Let me just delete this page right here. All right. So what I did is I added a page and I went and hunted down the template that we were just working in. Okay. Oops. Click the wrong one. Sometimes I'm too fast for my own good. Okay. So wherever you have your template saved, just navigate to it. And if you don't see this, right here where it's showing you how many slides there are. I did notice when I was playing with it earlier that Canva was being a little bit buggy for me and it wasn't giving this to me. So when I would click on this, it didn't show me individual pages. If that's happening to you, you may need to go back to the template itself and just do file, make a copy. That's how I was able to fix it. And the new copy worked better for me. So if Canva does something a little hokey with the template that you import from me, then just make a copy of it. And then you want it to show up like this when you click on the template, okay? Because then you're going to go and pick your slide. Now you'll see the 30-minute slide isn't there for me. That's just because I already had this open, this file, and so it didn't update. Let me see if I can get it to pull in here. If not, we'll just use one of the other ones. That's totally fine for now. Okay, I'm going to navigate back. Nope, I'm still just seeing the three pages. Okay, so it just hasn't like updated inside of Canva yet. So that's totally fine. I'm going to grab a 15-minute timer. So go over here, click on it, and it's going to pull it in just like this. So maybe I don't need that. Maybe I want to actually put it on an existing slide that's in this presentation. If I want to do that, I'm just going to copy and paste it to the other screen that I've already got created. But for right now, we're just going to work with this. So you want to just put the timer wherever you like, and then just go over to elements and find some cool shape to put behind it. That's kind of what makes this fun, right? Your shape needs to be white in order for this to kind of hide the shape of the cropping that you did there. So let's see, I'm just going to look for a rectangle and see what I get. All right. So you just want to pick something that you like, and just have it be something that matches your own branding, right? So here is, let's see, this one may not be quite as customizable as I like. So, you know, just play around with it until you find something. I'm going to try a different one. Let's see. Drawn rectangle or maybe painted rectangle. That one's kind of cool. And then just make it white so that it matches and position it backward. Okay. So that is an example of how you can do that. Now, the way that I got mine to look like this is I just duplicated the shape that I used and made it a different color. So it looks almost kind of like a little shadow. And then you're just going to design around it however you do your slides, Like I said, if you already have a slide template that you're using, instead you would just copy this over. And right now I have the two elements grouped together so you can move them around. However, if you need to, in order to work with the shape and kind of the spacing that you need, you can ungroup them. So that way you can space them out however you might need to. Okay. I'm just copying and pasting this. And we'll have to put it behind. Let's see. There we go. So that would be an example of how you can make a cute timer. All right. So that's really it. I'm going to put a link below for you to be able to grab your template and any other helpful links that I think might help you. And, you know, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and you want to hear from me again. So if you do, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. And I will see you next time, Ninja.